Have you arrived in the 21st century yet? Or is this still your impression of how a day boat should look? Short, fat, heavy, dumpy, slow, and in need of a mooring. Because around the turn of the century, a quiet revolution in day boats took place, led by the late great Noel Louvet. Monsieur Louvet realized the problems presented by the traditional day boat. Not much space in the cockpit for the crew, even less space in the cabin, so it was hardly ever used for sleeping in, not that you'd want to sleep in it if the motion was anything like this. Heavy bilge keels adding weight in order to keep the boat upright made it cumbersome to trail and also conspired with its dumpy shape to make it slow and boring to sail. Then there was the difficulty in finding a mooring, a difficulty common to all boats these days. And the uncomfortable motion in a seaway, whether moving or at anchor. So, Monsieur Louvet set out to solve all these problems in one fell swoop. He was inspired by the shape of this windsurf board, which was designed for ocean passage. And he got in touch with the architect, Guy Sayard, and together they invented a totally new genre of day boat. The open cockpit trimaran day boat. I received a fax. Yes, a fax. It was that long ago. Of a drawing of the new boat. And straight away, I knew it was going to be a winner. And within a matter of weeks, they went from an idea to a boat on show at the Paris Boat Show. And they called it the Magnum 21. Noel Louvet didn't know whether it was going to be a success, but he sold 7 boats at the Paris Boat Show, and eventually nearly 500 were built. It was a game changer. Here was a boat that had plenty of space for people to spread out. A boat that was fast and fun because it was light and wood plane. And the lightness meant it could easily be trailed, so you didn't need a mooring, though you could moor it if you wanted to. And trailing meant you could go and sail from a different harbour every weekend. And the speed meant you could get twice as far in a day as you could in the traditional day boat. Are you getting the picture? This boat created a revolution in day boat sailing. It was easy to rig, you could sail it on your own, you could do 12 knots with an outboard motor. The locker in the bows took the place of the cabin, which had only ever been used to stow things anyway. The early ones had just a mainsail and a jib, but over time extra sails were offered for better downwind performance. A smaller version was made, the Magnum 18, but they never made one with a cabin. The whole idea was to get rid of the cabin. And a more powerful version was made, with a taller mast, wider beam, and bigger sails. One great advantage of these trimarans was that they sail pretty well upright all the time. Now, I don't know why this should be, but that particularly appeals to the majority of women. Most women, not all, do not like boats that heel. I had one customer who said it was the fastest boat he'd ever owned, but the only one he'd ever been able to persuade his wife to go sailing in with him. But as the pound fell in value against the euro, these French boats became more and more expensive. And then came the recession. But now, the recession is over. And the pound has risen by 40% in value. And although production of the Magnum 21 ceased several years ago, there are other companies offering small trimarans like these. Astus make an 18-foot boat that remarkably is more spacious than the Magnum 21 was. And they put a little cabin onto the next size up, the 20-foot-long Astus 20.2 and the 20.2 Sport. And then they figured a way to make the cabin bigger without losing space in the cockpit. Remarkable. I've had some great little cruises around Cardigan Bay and in the West Country in the 20.2S. But if you want to accommodate four people in the cabin, then there is a 22-foot version. And now they have produced a 24-foot cruising trimaran. And all these boats utilize a similar folding system, so you can reduce the width for trailing and for narrow arena berths. And that is not the end of Astus's range of trimarans. Ever the innovator, Jean-Hubert Pommois has introduced his modern take on the motor sailor. Okay, it's not an ocean-going vessel. The clue is in the name, Baydream 5.5. But it is economical on fuel, fast, and you can motor upwind and sail downwind. It has a little cabin, and it's simple to rig. Launch it, turn the key to start, and you're away already. You see, nowadays, trimarans are everywhere. They're on the River Seine in Paris. I saw this harbour master in one in France. Ecologically friendly, economical and fast. This one holds the Jules Verne trophy for the fastest round the world record. So, what are you waiting for? Join the revolution. Buy a trimaran. You can download the current Astus price list below. And if you want to understand exactly why trimarans are so fast, then there's a link below that you can click.